Social distance. So
right.
I will do that as well. But great to be here, and I think I've had a long-standing relationship with Duty Brook, even back to my legislative days, and I've learned so much between my experience with you, as well as my wife Jackie, who former probation officer, you know, and all the great things that Duty Brook does. And it's great to see people are still spending a few dollars here or there to support Duty Brook, and I can't. Support, hey, that's not enough. We need more than $50,000 to keep Duty Brook going. So if you do have those extra dollars that are tight right now during these COVID times, please find a few there and support Duty Brook.
Thank you, Tom. Thank you. So I get to start off with Tom. I'm sure you could talk about forever what the city is doing during this time, but maybe the people would like to hear a little bit about you and Jackie and how you.
Well, you know, one thing growing up in LaPorte, my family taught me to give back. We were fortunate to have a community that supported us, and how important it is to give back. And so, I was never in politics growing up. I ran for the school board, had an opportunity to be a member of the school board, then 10 years in the legislature, and that's enough. You know, I think 10 years is plenty. Really was kind of set, figuring out what to do. We sold our manufacturing business and lived outside the city, so I kind of swapped Jackie and said, hey, I got an idea, and there was an opportunity for Blair Milo, who you're having on next week, is leaving. And so, how about we build a new house? She'd been begging, you know, saying, hey, we need a new house. How about we move one into the city and a wheel and deal? Let's get a house and let me run for mayor.
There you go.
I just love LaPorte, and I see there's so much opportunity. As I remind Mayor Perry, Valparaiso, Mayor Murphy, we're coming for it. LaPorte's going to be the place to be. We're very competitive, have a great team, and I'll tell you, with our lakes and parks, everybody wishes they have our natural resources, what we have. And you talk about our kids having the opportunity to have kids grow up in LaPorte. Experience that I think is something that will lead to their success.
I have to say, hidden gems all over.
Yes.
Hidden gems. We have our Duty Brook Dragonboat races at Stone Lake. Oh my goodness. Now I just drive there when I need a break because it's just absolutely gorgeous.
And peaceful. And by the way, UPS, you're lucky because we were coming for you in the Duty Brook races. We were putting a team this round together. Would have been going for it because I was not happy last year for taking a whipping like we did. So they're lucky. I can talk trash till next year.
There you go.
September 12th, and if you have not, 11th, but if you haven't experienced the Dragon Boat races, what a great time. And so look for 2021.
Yeah.
It's a great time. But we have a lot, you know, we like financing like everybody else are facing difficult times, but it gives us a chance to rethink how we do things and new ways to provide services. And as we talk, one of the things we're looking at is our police department. Right now, we only have approximately 37 to 40 officers. We know that's not enough, but what we have to look at, and I encourage all of our community members and residents to take a peek just the history of the 2018-2019 year-end numbers. As many calls as they go on, there's no way they can work at protecting our community. They're chasing their tail. And when I mean that, we're chasing dogs. We're chasing, you know, crimes against homes or something that doesn't include a person. But we're not working on the most important things that save lives. And as well, you know, we've started to look at why are we sending officers to maybe mental health issues or family.
Yes.
Why are we not coordinating more often with people like Duty Brook that are professionals that say, hey, the last thing a family might need that's having a disturbance is law enforcement coming with a gun? You know, why aren't we saying maybe this is a doom break for professionals or those that are having mental health issues, maybe the Swanson Center, and trying to say maybe the police need to step back from those situations and coordinate more and say let's let the professionals, because they, when we have issues happen in the court, it's like, well, we'll just add it to the police department, and we'll add it here, but versus saying, hey, a family that's having an issue doesn't need to see a police officer, they need to coordinate with Dubrook, and that's why, again, I would encourage everybody's support financially and otherwise to help support Dubrook, because if you're not here, where are your families turning to? And you don't know how good you had it until they're gone.
Right, and I think one of the things I hear you saying is when we're at home team meetings, for instance, our healthcare foundation has got a lot of the nonprofits together. When we hear what, for instance, the police department needs, you know, knowing what programs are out there is crucial. So it sounds like that's what you're talking about. In order to support the LaPorte Police Department, we need to step up, making sure they know that we're out here, or any other social service agency.
Absolutely. We're focused on the drug traffickers in our community. We don't have time to get into the neighborhood, but they also need to know, hey, if there's a disturbance, they may not be the best one to make that call. It might be a Dubrook, it might be Swanson Center, but you can't get it everywhere unless you have the support to keep going. So, yeah, it's interesting times. Obviously, with COVID, we're also, by the way, as we both say, we want to promote the state coming up through the month of July, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., Monday through Friday at the Civic. This test is not as intrusive as the other one where, you know, I've had the opportunity to get the, what I'll call the deep test, and it's quite interesting. You know, they pull out, you know, okay, where's everything else that fell out of my brain?
Yes, right.
I got to start picking that up. But,
right.
But,
so you're talking, Tom is talking free COVID testing. Civic Auditorium Building in LaPorte, the month of July, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. You do not, Monday through Friday, you do not need to have insurance. You don't even need to be a U.S. citizen.
Correct. And we encourage everyone.
Yes.
Undocumented. That's the thing. They will take your insurance, but they're not going to charge you individually. They will, you know, they may charge the insurance, but you will not pay anything out of pocket. And it's grown so quickly that they're now only allowing, I think, 24 walk-ins per day. So, highly recommend go onto the website of the Healthcare Foundation of LaPorte and pre-register. I think that's fair. It's the best way. And make it happen. And this test is so less intrusive. You get in, you get out.
So again, that what I hear you say, again, Tom, saying is the collaboration of if you're a citizen out there and you have a problem, whether it's you want to get testing or you need rent to pay because you've lost your job, please ask. You can call the city office, the city of LaPorte, the mayor's office. You can call Dubrook. We can tell you where to go. Please ask. I mean, that's what we find is that oftentimes people who are struggling don't ask. I mean, let's face it, it's difficult. You know, people, I know Salvation Army and the food banks, and, you know, they're seeing people who have never had to come to them before.
Correct.
So we all understand this is a really unique time, and there's a lot of people that need help that might not normally have reached out.
And Lisa Pierskowski,
he's a rock star.
It is anywhere that you turn or whatever you need, someone will be there to help. And we will get through this. This is unique time. There's no playbook to COVID, how you deal with it. That's why we put in a small ask. And I apologize to those that believe I'm infringing on their personal rights, but it is a piece of fabric. And we just want to keep, we want everybody to look in the mirror and not think of themselves. Let's think of everyone. You know, it's your grandparents, your grandchildren, your family, your friends. And I don't like this. I don't like wearing it, but everywhere medically, and I try to stick to the science. Let's try to do what we can. And I just saw the CDC yesterday said if we put these on for the next 6 weeks, we'll have a great opportunity of really knocking down COVID. And we're in
we have to get through it one way or another. So why not do something that helps us all? So thank you for saying that. Is there anything else the city would be going on in the city, Tom, that you want all of us to know about?
Well, it's funny. We just received a call yesterday from the Northwest Times to say, how could we have so many projects going on when other communities are just focused by COVID? I'll tell you. I will tell you, we're grinding every day, and we put a focus on being a small business all my life. It's like, you're going to face the up and downs. It's how you act, and you learn about people when times are tough. And our team, from Jessica Bruder to our entire planning, economic development, we are outpitching every day. And LaPorte is a place that is a community that businesses want to come to, and we need to provide good-paying jobs. We're also a part of cleanup, Jeff Batchelor, code enforcement, so that when people come in, they see a clean community. You know, it's the small things, the grass off the sidewalks coming in on Pine Lake, to homes. You know, there are the homes that you probably deal with, and we've had to condemn a couple because we have landlords that aren't setting a proper example. And no longer are we going to accept that. People shouldn't have to live in those type of conditions. People deserve respect and live with respect, and it starts with the home. These children, like you look out for, we're going to start providing options or looking at options for these people that are clean homes that they can be proud of.
Well, that's wonderful, Tom. And again, it sounds like it's, that same, we all are in this together. So there is a part of society that doesn't sometimes understand the desperate needs of people in any one of our communities. So we need to be cognizant of that. And so when you're having areas that need help, you're saying you're digging in with that, and you're looking and seeing what are the options to get them help and clean things up.
Absolutely. And if you need me, 363-7293 is my cell. You can text me. Tom Durbin, LaPorte Mayor, Facebook page. Follow that. And the City of LaPorte Facebook page. Things are happening. And so we encourage everybody to come hang out with us. And once again, support Doombrook. I'll kind of end it on there. And just a shout out to my friend over here, Amber Terry. She's a national guy, Max. I know her and her business extremely well. And you talk about community support and what they're doing. We connect. It's amazing for those individuals that just don't know where to turn or looking for a resource. Amber Terry is gold.
Thank you.
All right, I'll get out on that.
Tom, I just want to say thank you, and thank you for being the mayor of LaPorte. I know it's not an easy job. Any kind of leadership position is difficult, and I just truly want to say thank you to you and your family, because it is a family choice.
Yes, it is.
And all the best to Jackie and your family, and all the best to you, Tom, and thank you for what you do every day.
Thanks to Doombrook. We'll look forward to having you maybe at a city council meeting at your convenience and update the community all the good things you're doing.
Thank you, Tom. Thank you.
Bye.